every tent to rank before,
before
the wisest of humanity.
As gifts of head
and heart,
we're wasted on utility.
We're cast to play
a part
of great responsibility.
Our duty is
to spy
upon our king's initiatives
and keep a watchful eye
fly
on all his eccentricities. If ever a trick he tries that savors of rascality. At our decree he dies without the least formality.
Or newspaper publicity.
Our word is quite enough.
Enough.
The rest is electricity.
A pound of dynamite.
A mite.
Explodes in his auriculars.
It's not a pleasant sight.
Some sight.
We'll spare you the particular.
It's mortal men confess.
Confess.
The king needs no admonishing.
We may say it's success.
Success.
Is something quite astonishing.
Our
despot it imbues with virtues quite delectable. He minds his P's and Q's and Q's and keeps himself respectable.
Of a tyrant polite.
He's a paragon quite.
He's as modest as mine.
In his ways as a child.
Though no one are yet with his autocrat yet.
So delightfully planned for the best in the land. So delightfully planned for the best in the land. So
thank you. autocratic power we, a despot whose tyrannic will is law, whose rule is paramount o'er land and sea, a presence of unutterable awe. But though the awe that I inspire must shrivel with imperial fire, all foes whom it may chance to touch, to judge by what I see and hear, it does not seem to interfere with popular enjoyment much.
No, it does not interfere.
My subjects all, it is your wish emphatic that all Utopia shall henceforth be modeled upon that glorious country called Great Britain, to which some add, but others do not, I'll add. That being so, as you insist upon it, we have arranged that our two younger daughters, who have been finished by an English lady, a grave and good and gracious English lady, shall daily be exhibited in public, that all may learn what, from the English standpoint, is looked upon as maidenly perfection. Come hither, daughters.
To die of no more. rest. Oh, means of high and low decree, whose social code is rather free. Please look at us, and you will see what good young ladies ought to be.
Coral for his throne.
And strangers round you. Hello, cries the newborn baby. Where's my parents? Which may they be? Awkward silence, no reply. Puzzled baby wonders why. Father rises, bows politely. Mother smiles, but not too brightly. Doctor mumbles like a dumb thing. Nurse is busy mixing something. Every symptom tends to show you're decidedly de trop. Ho, 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 ho. I see totem if you spin it. If it's totem on a minute, I'll overlay you, hit the nail. And if you fail, the deuce is in it. Grow up and you discover what it is to be a lover. Some young lady is selected, poor perhaps, but well connected, whom you hail, for love is blind, as the queen of fairy kind. Though she's plain, perhaps unsightly, makes her face up laces tightly. In her form your fancy traces all the gifts of all the graces. Rivals none the maiden woo, so you take her and she takes you. Ho, 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 ho! Joke beginning never ceases till your ending time releases. On your way you blindly stray, and day by day the joke increases. 10 years later, time progresses, sours your temper, thins your tresses. Fancy then her chain relaxes, rates are facts and so are taxes. Fairy queen's no longer young, fairy queen has got a tongue. Twins have probably intruded, quite unbidden, just as you did. They're a source of care and trouble, just as you were only double. Comes at last the final stroke, time has had its little joke. Ho, 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 ho! Daily driven, wife has drove her ill, you've thriven, ne'er in clover. Lastly he went 60 and 10, and until then the joke is over. Ho, 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 ho! Daily driven, wife has drove her ill, you've thriven, ne'er in clover. Lastly he went 60 and 10, and until then the joke is over.
That forcible turn.
contemptible worm appeals to me most strongly to treat this pest as you suggest would pain my majesty great.
This writer lies.
Yes, bother his eyes.
He lives, you say,
in a sort of a way.
Then have been shot.
Decidedly not.
Or crash been flipped.
I cannot do
first my class, 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 first my class. and soldier seeks utopian glades in charge of youth and beauty. Then pleasure merely masquerades as regimental duty. By sword or pistol, by and by, which gentleman prefers to die, and which prefers survival?
It's clearly impossible, the round that fires your fleet is best about. We all the gentles never sought in plan for either rival, until we clearly testify by sword or pistol, by and by, which gentleman prefers to die, and which prefers survival?
If I should die and he should live, to you without reserve again, her heart so young and sensitive, and all her predilections.
If he should live and I should die, I see no kind of reason why you should not, if you wish it, try to gain her young affection.
If I should die and you should live, I see no kind of reason why you should not try to win her young affection.
If I should die and you should live to be an officer, I give a thousand young and sensitive and all her predilections. If you should live and I should die, I see no kind of reason why he should not, if he chooses, try to gain the young affections.
Happy intervention, a well-constructed plot, a well-constructed plot. When sages try to part, to loving hearts infusion, their wisdom's a delusion, and learning serves them not, and learning serves them not.
Until quite plain is their intent, the sages train I represent. Now please infer, let nothing low, nor henceforth, as it were, engaged to marry both. Then take it that I represent the two. On that hypothesis, what would you do?
What would I do? What would I do? In such a case, upon your breast, my blushing face, I think I'd rest. Then perhaps I might demurely say, I find this breastplate bright is sore in the way.
A mortal race is never blessed, there's no such perfect rest. Some petty blight asserts its sway, some crumpled rose leaf light is always in the way.
In such a case,
rest.
people. My beloved daughter most thoughtfully has brought with her from England the types of all the causes that have made that great and glorious country what it is.
Oh, joy on earth!
Why, what does this mean? What does it mean? What does it mean? What does it mean?
Attend to me, you talk in populace, you little island viviparians. All in the abstract types of courtly grace, yet when compared with Britain's glorious race, but little better than hawk-clothed barbarians.
Yes, I trust that when we Englishmen we're little better.
Cleanse the court from moral stain and purify.
tyranny promoted this with special education, which teaches what contango means and also backwardation. To speculators he supplies a grand financial leaven. Time was when two were company, but now it must be seven.
Yes, yes, yes. Time was when two were company, but now it must be seven. Stupendous loans to foreign thrones I've largely advocated. In ginger pops and peppermint drops I freely speculated. Then mines of gold of wealth untold successfully I floated. And sudden falls in apple stores occasionally quoted. And soon or late I always call for stock exchange quotation. No scheme too great and none too small for companification.
Yes, yes, yes. No scheme too great and none too small for companification.
The term I rather think is new to me. a company limited. What may that be?
What does it mean? What does it mean? You must have a kind of clue. What does it mean? What does it mean? What is he going to do?
Some 7 men form an association. If possible, all peers and baronets. They start off with a public declaration. To what extent they mean to pay their debts, that's called their capital. If they are wary, they will not quote it as a sum immense. The figure's immaterial, it may vary from 18 million down to 18 pence. I should put it rather low. The good sense of doing so will be evident at once to any debtor when it's left for you to say what amount you mean to pay. Why, the lower you can put it at, the better. They then proceed to trade with all who trust him, quite irrespective of their capital. It's shady, but it's sanctified by custom. Bank, railway, loan, or Panama Canal, you can't embark on trading too tremendous. It's strictly fair and based on common sense. If you succeed, your profits are stupendous, and if you fail, up goes your 18 pence. Make the money spin a spin, for you only stand to win, and you'll never with dishonesty be twitted. For nobody can know to 1 million or so to what extent your capital's committed. Come to grief and creditors are craving for nothing that is planned by mortal head is certain in this vale of sorrow, saving that one's liability is limited. Do you suppose that signifies perdition? If so, you're but a monetary dunce. You merely file a winding up petition and start another company at once. Though a Rothschild you may be in your own capacity, as a company you've come to utter sorrow. But the liquidators say, never mind, you needn't pay. So you start another company tomorrow.
But the liquidators say, never mind, you needn't pay.
It strikes us as dishonest, but if it's good enough for virtuous England, the first commercial country in the world, it's good enough for us.
You must take care, be redolent, we have not been consulted.
And do I understand you that Great Britain upon this joint stock principle is governed?
We haven't come to that exactly, but we're tending rapidly in that direction. The date's not distant.
We will be before you. We'll go down to posterity, renowned as the first sovereign in Christendom, who registered his crown and country under the Joint Stock Companies Act of 62.
America.
henceforward of a verity, with fame ourselves we link, we'll go down to posterity, our sovereigns all the pink.
If you come back to verity, our wishes are to ring, you'll go down to posterity much earlier than you think.
You'll go up to posterity if I inflict the blow.
You'll go down to posterity, we think we ought to know.
You'll go up, blown up with dynamite.
You'll go up, of course he will go right, go right, up, up, up.